The cylinder head, one on each bank, is a one-piece casting securely held to the cylinder block by special 11/16 inch bolts and hardened washers. The exhaust valves, fuel injectors, and valve and injector operating mechanism are located in the cylinder head. The four exhaust valves per cylinder are arranged in a trapezoidal configuration, with two valves set further apart than others. Exhaust valve seat inserts pressed into the cylinder head permit accurate seating of valves under varying conditions of temperature and materially prolong the life of the cylinder head. In this video, we're doing the cylinder head valve assembly for a 6V92 Detroit diesel. The 6V92 has two of these cylinder heads. This same cylinder head can be used in a 12V92 Detroit diesel, but in the 12V92, four of these cylinder heads are used. Here, Walter uses a lift to get the cylinder head onto his working bench. Next, he gathers the materials that he'll need for the valve assembly. Next, he does an inspection of the bare cylinder head to see that everything is in good condition. All new heads from Diesel Pro Power come with new inserts or valve seats. They come already refaced from the factory. The valves we offer at Diesel Pro Power do as well. The proper angle for the seating face of both the valve and the valve insert is 30 degrees. In this step, valve grinding compound is applied to the valves and the valve seat inserts. Now he is grinding the valve against the valve seat to ensure the valve will have a proper seating. He will repeat this process for all 12 valves. Next, he removes all compound and residuals of the valve grinding. Next, the valve spring seats are installed. Make sure the flat part of the washer is against the head. In this step, he will install the valve steam seals. They are also known as oil valve seals. Right after finishing installing the valve steam seals, he will prepare the exhaust valves for installation by lubricating them with special pre-assembled engine grease. Now he will install the valve springs by installing the valve cap and valve keepers. Then to compress the springs, he will use the J745 tool, which is threaded into the rocker shaft bolt holes in the cylinder head. Using the J745 tool, he applies pressure to the free end to compress the valve springs and install the valve locks. He repeats this process on each valve spring. In this final step, he uses a rubber hammer to ensure the valve keepers are not loose. After the valves have been installed, make sure that none of the valve heads protrude more than 2/1 of an inch. Here is the completed cylinder head for Detroit Diesel 6V92 and 12V92 with the valves installed.
Thank you for choosing Diesel Pro.